How much can you scale up 4K video on a 1080 timeline? Let's find out. Hi, I'm Stu, and welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. LumaFusion works differently from most non-linear editors in that rather than working to pixel dimensions for its video canvas, it works specifically to an aspect ratio. You don't really care whether it's 4K video, 1080p video, 720p video. It will all be sized to suit the aspect ratio rather than the pixel dimensions. The place where you upscale your videos is frame and fit. To get to it, all you either got to do is tap the pencil or just double tap on the video clip itself. It then automatically takes you into size and position. Now, when it comes to scaling 4K video within the 16:9 ratio, as you can see, you've got a little bit of room either side just by the nature of the 4K video and the way it's been captured. And then you can obviously decide how much you want to actually scale things up. Now, the maximum amount of scaling you can specifically do is 200%. If I just set that to 200%, so we're coming into that kind of distance. But that doesn't mean to say you need to set it to 200%. It's more of a limit, not a target, if that makes sense. And the reason for that is purely down to the optimum settings for scaling. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, it depends on how well the footage that you've got has been captured. So in other words, is the ISO, or effectively the digital noise, low enough so there's fine detail within the video? Focused on the point that you want to actually scale up to, is there a huge amount of depth of field? These are things you have to consider, as well as the exposure. Let me show you a couple of examples as to why you want to stick between 150 and 180% at maximum, rather than really pushing things to 200%. But don't get me wrong, what I'm telling you here is literally a guide. If you want to push your 4K video to 200% to crop right into something specific, you go for it. So obviously we're in frame and fit, we're at size and position, and we're going to be playing with the overall size. So if I come into, let's say, 159%, you can see that the quality of sharpness and the detail on the eyelashes and the pupil are just really nice and crisp. You can see the catch light, which obviously looks like a window, is really good looking as well. And then the zeros and ones for the binary code that's playing over the top looks good. Doesn't look too smudged or anything like that. Whereas if I go up to lights of 190 and take things even closer, we'll just reverse it back. You can see at 190, the zeros and ones for the binary code starts to look a little bit more smooshed out. It's more noticeable that you're zoomed into it, and it's just a little bit too far. And also the eyelashes and that are just starting to break down. So for the likes of this particular video, I probably wouldn't take it any more than around about 150 to 160%. This position here is a good position to be working to. And when it comes to keyframing this, is go to the end of the video first of all, and then keyframe the end. And then that way you can then go back to the beginning and then decide where you want to start from. So for example, I could reset the positioning and the size back here. I could then move the X position over a little bit. And then if I play things through the whole 8 seconds, it then comes into the eye the way I want it to, while still retaining the sharpness of the original video. So consider when you're filming that the ISO is as low as possible. It becomes harder to push and upscale 4K video if there's digital noise. The focus is on point, the depth of field is being managed correctly, and your exposure is pretty well done as well. If you have these four attributes working well for you, then you're going to be able to upscale things or have more flexibility in upscaling. If some of the attributes like the focus or the digital noise is increased, for example, you're on a higher ISO above, let's say, 400 ISO in Filmic Pro, then it gives you less flexibility. You would probably only work to about 110%, 120%, somewhere like that. Okay, from a second example of 4K video and upscaling it, we're looking at a little schoolboy here, and if we just play it through, you can see what's going on here. And the reason why I've picked this particular video is because of the animation, because it looks good in 4K at the full 16:9 ratio, but at the minute and second you start to zoom in, you will see things start to break down somewhat. Okay, this time to get into frame and fit, we're just going to press the number one keyboard shortcut. So once again, we will start at the back end of things and then zoom in and see where we can take it to. But if you look at the animation just now, and we're only at, we're only at 175.7%. So just keep in mind that if you're doing motion graphics or any kind of overlay titles or that, they need to be high enough a quality so that things are nice and crisp and sharp, especially if you're upscaling your 4K video. Just keep that one in mind. It's probably better to do the upscaling and then add any motion graphics or titles or that later, and then you'll get a better balance. So likes of this, again, I would think about bringing it back down to maybe about 140% or thereabouts. And the advantage of doing that is you can see the question marks. So once again, if I wanted to animate this, tap the plus sign in the keyframes, and then this time I could just start animating halfway through the video, say around about here, and we will reset things. And then that way, press play, we get the animation first of all, and then it starts to zoom in to the little boy. So you've seen the whole animation. And you're not going too far where the animation is really starting to break down. And because he's been shot under a sort of studio light scenario, he is going to be an awful lot more crisper and clearer than he would have been had this been with natural window light or that, or in a room just with low light where the digital noise and that is going to be coming back into the equation and degrading the image. Now, the last example I'm going to show you in this video tutorial is just a 1080p clip. Why are we talking about 1080p? Well, if you are using Filmic Pro and you want to be able to shoot Log V3, which allows you, if you're using an iPhone 12, to be able to capture 10-bit video, then if you're wanting to do slow motion, then the resolution has to be reduced from 4K to 1080p, and that will allow you to do 60 frames per second with a 24 frames per second playback. Capture that inside Filmic Pro and then get it on your timeline. Once again, we'll just go in, tap on the pencil icon. Now, how much can you zoom in? Well, I would say that you probably get away with 110%. So an extra 10% can be applied to, once again, good footage. And I wouldn't even say this is great footage, but it's an okay example. But good footage that has low ISO, spot on focus, managed depth of field, and an overall good exposure. In other words, the highlights aren't blown out, the shadows aren't too crushed. And if you take it to 110%, it just gives you that little bit of wiggle room to reposition things if you need to. And then from there, apply a keyframe to the end, go back to the beginning, and just double tap to reset all the different controls. And then if we play the whole 8 seconds, you'll see we're just got a little bit of a push in post. It's subtle, but it's there. So this is more for slow motion, captured in Filmic Pro, shot in 10-bit, log V3, and because you're shooting 10-bit, you'll get away with being able to upscale 1080p footage a lot more than you would do with other 1080p footage. And there you go, that's the video tutorial for today. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have, don't forget to give the video a thumbs up, that helps me out immensely. And if I've earned your subscription today, by all means subscribe to the channel, and also ring that bell for further notifications of other video tutorials coming out soon. And I'll catch you on the next one. See you later.